Welcome back. We have good news and bad news. The bad news first is that this is the last lesson in the course. The good news though, this is going to be the most awesome lesson in the course.
So to recap what we've learned so far, in lesson one we talked about what is UX and the difference between UI and UX. In lesson two, we talked about the user-centric design process and got into personas and use cases. In lesson three, we talked about the mobile user and talked about different mobile user constraints.
Yeah, in lesson four, we're going to talk about, not about constraints, but about the capabilities that are unlocked by mobile and the amazing things that you can do on Android to blow your users' minds and create amazing five-star applications.
So Nazmul, everybody wants to know, how do we get closer to making five-star apps?
That's a great question. First, we're going to understand the amazing capabilities that the Android platform has to offer. Then we're going to imagine how to use these capabilities to create some really kick-ass features for your apps. And through all this, we're going to learn that context is what helps us deliver five-star applications to our users.
So Nazmul, what do you mean by context?
So context is all about a user and what they're doing in a physical environment when they're interacting with your application. Now, before we get into the details of what context is made up of, you're probably a web and desktop developer. So let's talk about the differences between the Android platform and web and desktop. There's some fundamental similarities between web desktop and mobile machines. I mean, after all, they actually collect data from input sources, they process that information, and they produce output. So what are some of the inputs, do you think, that are similar between web desktop and Android?
Well, they both have keyboards, and you can enter information that way. And they also both have pointing devices. And they both have a network connection.
Yeah, there are a lot of similar input sources, but the power of Android truly lies in the input sources or sensors that are available on Android that are simply not available on web and desktop.
Exactly.
One simple example is GPS. So can you name all the other input sources that are available on Android that are not available on web and desktop?